Okay, good afternoon to one and all. This is Gopi Krishna, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering from Chevrolet Engineering College. Subject is Compiler Design. So in previous class, we are going to discuss about how to construct a syntax tree and syntax-directed translation. So today we are going to discuss syntax-directed translation scheme. Okay. So this is the topic we are going to discuss today, right? So here, what is the syntax-directed translation? In previous class, we are discussing syntax-directed translation. So what is syntax-directed translation? So it is same as the syntax-directed definition. What is syntax-directed definition? So in syntax-directed definition, we are having only a context-free grammar are associated with semantic rules. Okay, so that is the syntax directed definition. What is the syntax directed translation? So in this syntax directed translation, we are having a context free grammar with semantic rules, and those semantic actions that are specified at anywhere in the right side of production. Okay, so that is the syntax directed translation, right? So in previous class, we are going to discuss two examples. So how to construct the syntax tree and what is the syntax directed translation. Okay, is there any doubt with that one? So here, syntax directed translation scheme. So here, here is the example. Translation scheme that convert a infix expression to postfix expression for the given grammar and also generate the annotated parse tree for the input string 2 plus 6 plus 1. Okay, so what is annotated parse tree? A parse tree which contains the values at each node is known as the annotated parse tree. So here we are using the translation schemes that convert infix expression to postfix expression. So here is the expression 2 plus 6 plus 1. So we are having the grammar is e produces e plus t and print plus. So this is the translation scheme. So we are writing translation schemes e produces e plus t print plus semicolon and closed bracket and beta. Okay. So t produces 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on 9. So this is the given grammar. We have to generate the translation scheme for that grammar. So the what is the grammar here? E produces E plus T and printf plus in single quotes semicolon closed bracket or T and T produces 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is the given grammar. We have to convert this grammar to translation scheme. So translation scheme telaras parante. So in this grammar, we are having any left recursion. We have to eliminate the left recursion. So what is the production that having the left recursion? The production is in the form of A produces A alpha or beta. So that is the production. We can say that production is in the form of left recursion. Okay, we have to eliminate the left recursion by using the these two productions. So we have to eliminate the left recursion. So here A produces A alpha or beta, and that A produces beta A dash, and A dash produces alpha A dash and epsilon. So this is the elimination of left recursion. We use these two expressions, these two productions. We have to eliminate the left recursion. What is the left recursion? So the production is in the form of A produces A alpha or beta. That production is in the left recursive production. We have to eliminate that left recursion by using these two productions. So here the productions are A produces beta A dash and A dash produces alpha A dash or epsilon. So we have to eliminate the left recursion by using these two productions. So here the production is E produces E plus T and printf print plus semicolon closed bracket R. So this is in the form of A produces A alpha or beta. Okay, so here we have to eliminate the left recursion here. So by using these two productions, we have to eliminate the left recursion. So the production becomes E produces T. So what is the beta production? Capital T. So by using capital T, and we are using E, A produces E alpha or beta, A dash becomes P. So why we are using this P? So we are converting A infix expression into post fix expression. So that's why we are using this P. Okay, so we can use any symbol in this P. Okay, in previous class we are using to eliminate the left recursion, we are using capital R, that means the remaining part we are using R. So here we are converting infix expression into postfix expression by using P. So we can represent P is conversion of infix to postfix. So postfix means, so we are specifying the capital P into that one. Okay, so E produces T and P. E produces T, P. So P is the postfix expression, right? And next remaining, so A dash produces. So here is the A produces beta A dash. A produces beta A dash. So that means E produces beta is T and A dash is P. And A dash means P. P produces. So what is the remaining alpha part? So plus T open brace print plus semicolon closure brace, and this total becomes the alpha, and we are having P. So P means A dash. So here A dash produces alpha, A dash or epsilon. So finally we are using P produces epsilon also. Okay, so P means we are writing A dash here. So P produces epsilon. And what are the remaining productions? So T produces 0 or 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 and so on, 9. So what is the production? T produces 0. Then what is the semantic action here? Print within the brackets, we are using single quotes 0 and semicolon, close the curly brace. So that is the semantic action that are performing in the current given production. So this is the production, T produces 0. Then what is the semantic action here? Print 0 on semi in single quotes. We are using this the semantic action. So T produces 1, T produces 2 and so on, T produces 9. So we are using the semantic actions are within the curly brackets. We are using print 0, print 1, print 2, print 3, print 4 and so on, like that print 9. So this is the given translation scheme for the given grammar. So the grammar is E produces E plus T within the curly bracket, print in single quotes plus semicolon, close the curly brackets, or beta. And T produces 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, 9. So that is the given grammar. So how to generate the translation scheme? So in this given example, so translation scheme that converts a infix expression to postfix expression for the given grammar, and also generate the enumerated parse tree for the input string 2 plus 6 plus 1. So that means we are using two steps here. So what are the two steps? So we have to generate the translation scheme for the given grammar, and then we have to construct the enumerated parse tree. So we are using two steps to we are solving this problem. Okay, so here we are, the first step is completed. That means translation scheme we are writing. So E produces T, P, and P produces plus T, and print plus semicolon and P. So P produces epsilon and T produces 0. What is the semantic action? Print 0, print 1, print 2, print 3 and so on, print 9. Okay, so this is the generation of translation scheme. Okay, so is there any left recursion in the given grammar? We have to eliminate the left recursion by using the these two productions. So the production is in the form of A produces A alpha or beta. Then we have to eliminate the left recursion by using the production is A produces beta A dash and A dash produces alpha A dash or epsilon. Okay, so that is the elimination of left recursion. So this is the given grammar, and this is the we have to find the step one is translation scheme. So what is the step two? we are generating the annotated parse. So we have to construct the first, we have to construct the parse tree for this translation scheme. Then we are converting that parse tree into annotated parse tree. Okay, so here is the translation scheme. We have to construct the parse tree. So here is the here is the productions. E produces TP and P produces plus T open brace print plus closed brace and P. So P produces epsilon, T produces zero. So here is the semantic actions. So we are specifying the semantic action. Why? Because so here is the values. Then we are using the semantic actions are print 0, print 1, print 2, and so on, print 9. So how to construct the parse tree for the given input string? So the input string is, the input string is 2 plus 6 plus 1. So that is the given input string. So we have to construct the parse tree here. Okay, so we are constructing the parse tree. We have to take the what is the starting production of the translation scheme. So what is the starting production? E produces TP is the starting production. So we are considering this this production. So we have to construct the parse tree. So here E produces TP. Okay, so what are the productions including T? So here we are having 10 productions with the with non-terminal capital T. Okay, so here T produces
sir,
zero.
Voice cut out, sir.
Okay, na. No, bro, okay, na.
No, sir.
Huh?
Cut out, na.
Cut out, na. ఇప్పుడు హలో హలో హలో
ఓకే సార్
రైట్ ఇది సిగ్నల్ ప్రాబ్లం కొంచెం ఇప్పుడు ఓకేనా
ఎస్ సార్
రైట్ So these are the productions. So translation schemes means translation schemes means syntax directed translation. So we are using a syntax semantic action. We are placing the production. So here is the productions. E produces TP and P produces. So we are eliminating the left recursion in this one. Okay. Then the productions are this one. T produces zero. So the semantic action is print zero. Semicolon and closing curly braces. So these are the productions here. So we have to construct the in parse tree for the input string 2 plus 6 plus 1. So we are going to construct the parse tree. Then what is the first step we are using? So what is the starting symbol, starting production that are present in our translation scheme? So here the starting production is E produces TP. So we are considering this production. So E produces TP. In this TP, so T we are having 10 productions. Right? What is T produces 0, T produces 1, T produces 2, like that. So in our input string, what is the value? First one, 2. So then we are converting the T with 2. Then what is the semantic action here? Print 2, semicolon. Closed bracket. Okay, so why we are using 2 means based on the input string we have to construct the parse tree. Okay, what is the input string here? 2 plus 6 plus 1. Then we are considering T produces 2. Then what is the semantic action here? Print 2 semicolon closed curly brace. And so T is over. Then P, coming to P, so we have how many productions with P? So we are two productions with capital P. So we are using epsilon. So our input string is 2 plus 6 plus 1. Then there we are taking P produces epsilon. So we can end the parse tree. Then we are considering the production. P produces plus T, print plus semicolon, closed break, and So we are using this production. So we have to generate the parts. So P produces plus T print plus comma P. So we are having three symbols at the right hand side. So those are plus and T print plus and P. So these are the three symbols that are having the production capital P. So plus T and P. In this one, so 2 plus. So this T becomes, what is the production with T becomes 6. Why? Because in our input string 2 plus 6 plus 1. So we are using 6 here. So T produces 6. What is the semantic action here? Print 6 semicolon closed curly brace. And again this P. So in our input string 2 plus 6 plus 1 also. Okay, so we are getting 2 plus 6, then P, we are having the epsilon. So we are using this production. So no need to construct the parse tree with plus 1. So we can stop the parse tree. So that is the reason why we are using the production. P produces, again, P produces plus T, print, plus and P semicolon. Semicolon, close curly brace and P. Okay, so we are using P, so plus T print plus semicolon close curly brace and P. So this T becomes T produces 1. Why? Because in our input string 2 plus 6 plus 1. So in this 2 plus 6 plus 1. So we are writing 1 print 1. And so P produces, again P produces 2 productions. We are using this production or this production. So we are getting the input string 2 plus 6 plus 1. So no need to use the production P plus T print plus semicolon closed curly brace P. So we can simply write P produces epsilon. Why? Because the input string is completed. So we have to construct the parse tree here. Okay. So this is the given input string. This is the parse tree. Okay. Is there any doubt with the parse tree? E produces TP first one. So T is converting to print. So this is a semantic action. So P, we are having two productions. So we are using this production. So P produces plus T print plus P. And we are using 6. Then P produces again plus T P. Okay. Then here we are using T produces 1 print 1. And P produces epsilon. Why? Because so P, there is no need to use another time. Plus T print plus P. Why? Because so our input string is only 2 plus 6 plus 1. So we are getting the leaf set 2 plus 6 plus 1. So no need to expand the this P. So this is the parse tree for the given input string 2 plus 6 plus 1. Okay. Then we are constructing a parse tree. After constructing the parse tree, we have to convert those parse tree into annotated parse tree. So what is annotated parse tree? A parse tree which contains values at each node, that is called the annotated parse tree. So in this parse tree, we are traversing from top to bottom and left to right. Then only we have to print that particular conversion of infix to postfix. So the infix expression is 2 plus 6 plus 1. Now what is the postfix expression? We are using the annotated parse tree, we can get the result of infix to postfix. So by using top to bottom and left to right traversal, so if there is any reduction, we have to place that semantic action and perform the next one. Okay, so that is the traversing by using top to bottom and left to right. Okay, here. So we are moving from top to bottom. So here 2. What is the semantic action here? Print 2. So we are printing 2 here. Then we are moving left to right. So here E produces TP. So there is no production with E produces TP, but there is no semantic action. So we are moving downwards. We are moving downwards and plus. Then here T. So we are moving next one. T produces 6. So is there any here we are having the reduction, then we have to print the 6. So we are printing 6 here. Then we are moving top upwards, and here also. So T produces, we are having the semantic action, then perform the semantic action, that is a print plus. So we are printing plus, then moving down, next plus. So we are getting this plus, no need to print this plus. Why? Because we are having the semantic actions with print. So then only we can print that particular symbol or particular value. Okay, no need to print this plus. Then we are moving downwards, then here is the reduction. We have to perform the semantic action. So that is a one. So one is we are printing, then moving upwards. So print plus. So plus is the next reduction. So we are going to print the plus. And lastly, we are moving P produces epsilon. So epsilon is the empty one. No need to print the there is no semantic action. So there is no reduction here. So this is the finally we are constructing the enumerated parse tree for converting a infix expression to postfix expression. So here is the input infix expression, that is 2 plus 6 plus 1. What is the postfix expression? 2 6 plus 1 plus. So this is the conversion of a infix expression into postfix expression by using the syntax directed translation schemes. Okay, this is the topic today. Is there any doubt? Anyone?
No, sir. No, sir.
So, this topic to manki third unit aipoyindamma. Okay.